Aamir Khan, also known as Mr. Perfectionist of the Hindi film industry and regarded as the Daniel Day-Lewis of India, has been a rocksteady cornerstone in Bollywood for over 25 years now and is widely considered to be the greatest actor in India who emerged into mega stardom. Aamir has been widely known and praised for taking up complex roles in his acting career and going through some really impressive physical transformations in order to get into the skin of his characters and to suspend the logic of disbelief for the audiences watching in theaters. And how does it pay off, you ask? Well, he has hands down been the greatest box office draw for the past decade or so, constantly beating other industry behemoths like Salman Khan and Shah Rukh Khan in the process. Starting from Gajni in 2008, it's only Aamir Khan movies that have managed to claim the mantle of the biggest hit in Bollywood history. So you know how Thugs of Hindostan is going to do, right? On that note, we now take a look back at some of the greatest movies that Aamir Khan has starred in to date. And remember, the ranks are based on content only, and there's a spoiler alert in order. With that said, this is Aamir as well, and here are 10 best movies starring Aamir Khan. Number 10, Rangeela.
Munna, I'm sorry.
This 1995 romantic comedy followed a middle-class actress Millie to be unknowingly trapped in a love triangle between her childhood best friend Munna and a famous film star Raj Kamal. The film portrays the feeling of jealousy on Munna's part beautifully as he sees Millie spending more time with the film star. What follows are a series of Munna's own tactics to woo Millie by taking her out to these luxury hotels but knowing nothing of how to behave there.
Hey, Tambi, idhar aa.
Sir.
Yes, sir. What can I do for you?
Correct, yeah.
The underrated movie did a lot in its time of release, like establish Aamir Khan as a legitimate actor in the eyes of the mainstream audience, introduce A.R. Rahman to Bollywood with a bang, catapult Ram Gopal Verma to a legendary status, before he killed all his aura later on, and give the audiences Urmila Matondkar. Yes, the woman from Bhoot and Gone. All in all, Rangeela was a light-hearted drama that did not take itself too seriously and inspired Hollywood remakes in the future. Number 9, Ghulam. Stop. A coming-of-age film revolving around two brothers working for a don in the area, Khan plays the role of Siddharth, an amateur boxer who, despite aspiring to be a goon himself, follows a strict moral code thanks to his father's teachings. Ghulam's beauty lies with how each brother perceives their father's teachings, his untimely death during their childhood, and the cause of that death. Now, I'm not going to spoil a lot of the backstory here, but know that it's something that you will not see coming when it does happen. The redemption arc that Siddharth goes through after his friend has been killed is something Aamir Khan plays to perfection. It's amazing to realize how Khan performed his own stunts in the movie, particularly the one where he runs towards an oncoming train, which misses him by a mere 1.3 seconds difference as he jumps off the tracks. Ghulam is a gem celebrated more for its songs nowadays, but deserves to be looked at as one of the best Aamir Khan starters. Number 8, Dil Chahta Hai.
Oh God, she was a crook.
The debut directorial by Farhan Akhtar in 2001, Dil Chahta Hai revolved around the post-college life of three best friends and their poles apart approach to relationships. Khan, co-starring in the movie alongside other A-list actors like Saif Ali Khan, Preeti Zinta, and Akshay Khanna, played the role of Akash Malhotra, an irresponsible son of a wealthy industrialist, and how he treated relationships. The movie, which was loosely based on Shakespeare's comedy Much Ado About Nothing, was set up in urban Mumbai and Sydney and marked a great start to 2000s with its more regular setting. It proved to be a trendsetter with time, as there are still movies being made right now portraying some friends and a point of conflict in their lives that ultimately changes their relationships with each other. All in all, while it did not set the box office on fire upon release, Dil Chahta Hai has managed to withstand the test of time and has secured a cult following for itself over the years, while some consider it to be the best Aamir Khan movie, period.
Maan gaye Sid, teri choice to bilkul.
Number 7, Jo Jeeta, Wohi Sikandar.
और तुमने झूठ बोला तो अपनी मकारी छुपाने की। कल तक मैं थापड़ का बेटा था तो तुम्हें पसंद था, अब मैं एक मामूली इंसान का बेटा हूँ तो अचानक मुझ में कीड़े पड़ गए।
Speaking of trendsetters, an older Aamir Khan starrer which inspired remakes in different languages across the country was his 1992 sports drama Jo Jeeta Wohi Sikandar. Constantly being overshadowed by his elder brother, Khan played the role of Sanjay Lal Sharma, who was always compared to his more popular and widely beloved brother. The film, which also featured inter-college rivalries, relationships, and a cycling marathon to cap it all off, becomes a battle between Sanjay and the inter-college champion Shekhar when Sanjay starts wooing his girlfriend. What follows is a series of events and unexpected dark turns in Sanjay's quest to finally redeem himself in his own eyes and to his father. Khan brought life and color to an otherwise easy-to-be-hated character towards the first half at least, and made the audiences genuinely root for him, even when he was occasionally wrong. His cheerful personality was all that was needed for the viewers to connect and feel for him at his most vulnerable situations. Jo Jeeta Wohi Sikandar was one of the few underdog stories before and during its time, and managed to sweep most of the awards that year. Number 6, Taare Zameen Par.
Ho gaya beta, aa jao ab.
Main kabhi batlata nahi, par andhere se darta hoon main maa.
So the three Khans of Bollywood today are quite criticized for being the front and center of any film that they're a part of. Producers want them to be the focal point of their narratives, since they're the money movers after all. And so supporting cast and lead female actors are reduced to irrelevance in their films. And then we get Taare Zameen Par, which was not only Aamir Khan's home production, but also his directorial debut, where he played a supporting role to the 8-year-old Darshil Safari. The movie follows Ishan, a young boy suffering from reading dyslexia, but is perceived to be a duffer given his lazy attitude towards studies. He forms a passion in art from a very young age and finally starts finding his groove with the help of his art teacher at his new boarding school. Taare Zameen Par was arguably the most emotionally charged film that Aamir Khan has ever starred in, eliciting tears from the audience at various parts of its runtime. It was a super successful debut for Khan in direction, which was not only India's official entry to the Academy Awards in 2007, but also won so many national awards that there's an entirely separate page on Wikipedia listing the film's accolades alone. The film was endorsed by the International Dyslexia Association and screened in various parts of the world as part of their movement. While Secret Superstar was a good follow-up to the point Khan tried to make in this movie, there's no denying that Taare Zameen Par was arguably the most influential movie of its time.
Isme ilaaj ki shakti hai. Ek maram hai jisse dard mitta hai.
Main bhi to dekhun. Aisa kya sikha diya tere coach saab ne, jo tera baap na sikha paya.
Yo angutha is tarah dal ke.
Number 5, Dangal.
Jo sikha tere coach saab ne, is tarah jeetegi international medal.
Being the latest Aamir Khan starrer, Dangal revolved around a former wrestler who gives up his hopes of gold medal when he couldn't have a son, but ends up choosing his daughters at a very young age to do the deed. Mahavir Fogat, played by Khan himself, became his daughter's mentor, teacher and trainer for the better part of their teenage lives. Dangal follows this family over years from small arenas in Balali, where women doing anything but cooking is a myth, to international Commonwealth Games. Now everybody acknowledges Khan's several physical transformations throughout the film to portray Mahavir in different ages, but equal credit should be given to the four newcomers who played his daughters Geeta and Babita at different ages. The female actors went through some serious wrestling training and had to endure physical injuries along the way, all while preparing to act in their first movie. What resulted were some of the most convincing roles played on screen in 2016, and no one could tell if it was their first movie, period, let alone as a wrestler of all things. Dangal was a massive success and went on to become the biggest Hindi film to date. Without any commercial Bollywood flavor of romance, over-the-top action, or party sequences, the movie stands as the biggest box office hit in Hindi film industry right now. Number 4. Earth.
इतना आसान नहीं अपना घर छोड़ना.
Going from his most popular film to one of his least recognized films today, Earth was a political period drama based on the 1991 autobiography Cracking India by Bapsi Sidhwa. Earth, which was the second installment in Indo-Canadian filmmaker Deepa Mehta's Elements trilogy, was set in 1947 Lahore in the same time period directly before and during the partition of India and formation of Pakistan. The movie featured Khan alongside Rahul Khanna, Maya Setna, and Nandita Das in pivotal roles and depicted the true horrors of the partition period, from raging tensions between the different religious groups like Hindus, Muslims, and Sikhs, to all-out massacres and slaughter that was later regarded as independence. Mehta did not shy away from telling anything she wanted to say through the film. It was a brave attempt to highlight the darker side of 1947 and the hostilities surrounding it. Now, we've all studied in history how entire trains carrying people migrating to their desired cities after partition were slaughtered on both sides, but when we actually saw it in the movie, the scene sends shivers down our spine. Not to spoil anything, but the ending in particular will leave you uncomfortably speechless for the moment. Earth was another movie of Khan sent as India's official entry to the Oscars in 1998. While it did not make it to the final five nominees, the movie is a gem and a commentary on society that was not at all taken lightly upon release. Number 3. Three Idiots. While Earth was a dark social commentary on the religious system, Three Idiots was another social commentary, but on the educational system in India. The movie was universally loved for its light-hearted approach at some serious issues like student suicides, parental pressure, and the meaning of success. Revolving around the college life of three friends for the most part, the movie followed Raju, Farhan, and Rancho. Three friends having different aspirations of life, but ending up in the same engineering college. Hirani primarily uses parallel narrative structure to simultaneously show their college years and 10 years in the future when Raju and Farhan set on a road trip to find their mysteriously disappeared friend. Three Idiots was a thought-provoking movie to say the least. It shed light on an issue which is usually neglected in today's society in favor of everything else like politics and religion. Impressive performances by the main cast including Khan, Sharman Joshi, Madhavan, Boman Irani, and Omi Vaidya took viewers for a roller coaster of emotions, including laugh riots in theaters watching that epic silencer speech, and all those tear-jerking moments like when Raju and Farhan thank Rancho. All in all, Three Idiots is one of those rare movies in Bollywood which we can watch over and over without getting tired. Number 2. Lagaan.
शरत मंजूर है।
If we were to divide Aamir Khan's career into two periods, similar to BC and AD, we will have a period before Lagan and the one after it. Before Lagan, while his movies weren't struggling that bad on box office, there was nothing really to Aamir Khan. While his contemporaries had created a niche for themselves in the industry, Khan was kind of in a limbo. Having done movies like Mann and Mela just prior, he was just another star in Bollywood trying his best not to sink in. And then, Lagan happened. Lagan, which was also the first home production by Khan himself, was directed by Ashutosh Gowarikar and revolved around the British rule on India and how the residents of a small village agreed to play a game of cricket, which by the way they had no idea of, against their British rulers just to get their following year's tax cancelled if they won. What follows is a tale of determination, teamwork, deception, and survival. Lagan became the third highest grosser of the year upon release, despite following such an unorthodox subject and not being a cliched Bollywood masala film that audiences had been conditioned to expect for decades before it. It became the first Indian film to ever receive an Oscar nomination, and if there's something to be credited for how Khan chooses his projects now, it's Lagan. The movie was hailed by the audiences and critics alike, showering their praises on the story, direction, and casting choices, and won 8 national awards along with over 30 other Indian film awards. And number 1, Rang De Basanti.
जैसो की कोई औकात ही नहीं यार। अच्छा जैसे लाखों मर जाए ना फिर भी कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा, कुछ नहीं बदलेगा।
While there have been great movies depicting the lives and struggles of the few freedom fighters of India during the British rule, there's no question that Rang De Basanti hailed supreme amongst all of them. Directed by Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra, the movie told the epic tale of Bhagat Singh and his companions in a more indirect way, as a group of 6 modern, laid-back youngsters are hired by an English woman to play the roles of these freedom fighters for her documentary. The viewers then get to see the struggles of those historic figures through these modern actors and how it changes their own lives forever. Mehra spent around 7 years on the script before production with assistance from 3 separate writers, including Khan himself, and it's rightly justified in the final product. All the characters in the movie were brilliantly fleshed out and felt complete. They all had an arc that they were following and affected respectively according to which historic figure they ended up playing in the documentary. The movie's climax was inspired by a recent incident that happened at that time in India and fit perfectly in the narrative, although it stirred massive controversies upon release. The movie helped youngsters recognize that they can also contribute to the nation rather than waiting for the best time to leave India and study abroad. Rang De Basanti is arguably Khan's best film right now, and it's shocking to realize that his initial response to the script was negative.
कुछ कर गुजरने को खून चला आँखों के शीशे में उतरने को खून चला बदन से टपक कर जमी से लिपट कर गलियों से रस्तों से उभर कर उमड़ कर।
And there you have it guys, 10 greatest Aamir Khan movies. don't agree with our list, please make sure to comment down below. Please subscribe to this channel as there will be more exciting content here shortly. You can follow me on social media here. My name is Aamir, and I'll see you soon.